I'm Michelle Rivard for Daytime Toronto on Rogers TV. I'm here at Loblaw's at Maple Leaf Gardens at 60 Carlton Street. Joining me is Marcello Piane. He is the store director here at the new Loblaw's. How are you doing today?
I'm well. How are you? Welcome to Loblaw's.
Thank you so much. It is my first time actually here at this store. Obviously, this place needs no introduction. Maple Leaf Gardens is very iconic in Toronto. Loblaw's is new here to this space, though, correct?
It is. We've been here open to the public for almost 2 months now.
Awesome. And obviously, there was a pretty big renovation process that it took to transform this place from an ice arena and sporting venue to a grocery store. What has Loblaw's done here to honor the history of Maple Leaf Gardens?
Well, what we've done is when we actually started the construction, we wanted to do our best to actually preserve the four walls as it is a historical site. If you look here right over your shoulder, you'll notice that as we were doing the demolition, we thought it'd be pretty neat to kind of keep the original wall and pay homage here to Maple Leaf Gardens. You'll notice a Toronto Maple Leaf sculptured with about 128 original seats. And if you look even further up, you'll see some of the original lights that used to once hang here at Maple Leaf Gardens. So again, we wanted to do our best to respect the heritage here in Toronto and Maple Leaf Gardens, and also to respect the tradition as best we can.
That's great. So we're going to do a little tour of the store. You've got some kind of unique features. Can you tell me about, I heard that what lies right in the center of the store?
Yes, we actually have a spot where center ice used to once be in aisle 25, and it's pretty cool because especially over the weekends we have a lineup of customers that do their best to take their picture by center ice.
Well, that's great because there's going to be a lot of really iconic face-offs that took off there, and I think that's awesome that you have that still incorporated.
Yeah, that's right. It's a cool project to be a part of. The community here loves it, and there's a lot of customers that actually come from the outskirts of the GTA just to obviously see the building, see what's new and unique in store, and obviously to see center ice.
Yeah, and over here we have a mural. This mural is a replica of one that was originally in Maple Leaf Gardens.
That's correct. A while back we actually had somebody paint this mural down in Maple Leaf Gardens, and we wanted to actually preserve it as best we can, so it's obviously replicated, and we have some of the original chairs, the golds and the reds that used to once be here in Maple Leaf Gardens as well.
Let's tell me a little bit about what makes a unique shopping experience here at the new Loblaw's.
A unique shopping experience. So we got anything from Ace Bakery, where we produce a lot of breads from scratch. We got our 18-foot high cheese wall, which it's almost an attraction in itself. We have our wonderful patisserie here with enough sweets to stimulate your senses on a daily basis. We have a unique kitchen offering where everything that's made fresh in store that's available to our customers is made in store from scratch. Same thing here with our donuts, our muffins are all made here from scratch as well.
So you're really taking the time to make, like, most of the food I see in here is made fresh daily?
You got that right. Yeah. Our motto is fresh first, and we want to do our absolute best to provide the best customer service out there.
That's awesome. And so what is this area? This is the canteen?
Yeah, so this is the canteen. It's a first for Loblaw's. So because we're in an urban community, we want to do our absolute best to make the best of both worlds. So whether it's a customer that's coming in that wants to grab a quick bite, or if a customer wants to come in and do a big shop and then have a quick bite as well, or for the convenience shop. So we try to make the best of both worlds when it comes down to the urban market.
And I see here on the tables, it looks like there's some imagery from maybe previous events?
Yeah, that's right. So there's about seven tables here, and each one is dedicated to either hockey, music, the circus, wrestling, any type of historical events that have taken place here. We've done our best to preserve those in artifacts.
That's cool. And I see here a deli, and it looks like we have, is this like a meat curing going on?
Yeah, well, it's where we hang a lot of our prosciuttos and a lot of our dried meats. Customers love it. Customers love to see the different interaction when it comes down to fresh offering and our knowledgeable staff behind the counter. And again, we have everything segmented in different areas so that when the customer comes in, if it's ham, if it's chicken, if it's prosciutto, they just kind of go right to that, and we're just kind of making a statement.
Cool. And I hear that you have a President's Choice Cooking School.
We do. Actually, on our second floor, we have the President's Choice Cooking School, where we offer anything from corporate functions to corporate events to kids' birthday parties. And we have a dine-in with a chef that's after 5 p.m. on Thursday to Sunday, or you can have an experience with your party and a chef. and he will create, he or she will create whatever it is you want from scratch.
That's so neat. So is that something that people can book, or is it, do you drop in classes?
We actually do a little bit of both.
Yeah.
So you can come in and you can book, or you can come in and drop in. Whatever suits your needs. But we basically have pamphlets. We have an on-site cooking coordinator that will book anything for you or your party or your for your corporate events.
Awesome. And obviously we can look around and see it's pretty busy. You guys have been busy since opening?
That's right. It's been a pretty steady flow. We're actually pretty content with the amount of customer traffic that's coming in and out of the store.
And now you're here all the time, but did you grow up in Toronto?
I actually did. I was born and raised in Toronto, just about 20 minutes north of here.
And do you have a favorite memory from Maple Leaf Gardens?
I actually remember coming to Maple Leaf Gardens with my dad as a kid, and I remember the roof leaking.
Oh.
But ever since then, just coming to the gardens a couple times a year to catch a game or to catch a circus was something that will always stick in my mind. And the same feeling I got coming in here as a kid is the same feeling I get coming in here as a colleague here for Loblaw. So
that's really exciting. I'm so glad that it's so much heritage and so much history in this building. It really feels like it's being honored. It's great.
Yeah, that's right.
And I read just today that as crews were renovating here, that there was a time capsule that was found that was put in 1927 by Conn Smythe.
It was actually 1931.
Okay.
As the building was being built, rumor has it that he put the box somewhere and it was hidden. It was found just a couple months back, but the big unveiling will be in a couple days. So stay tuned.
Do you think the secret to a Toronto Maple Leaf Stanley Cups might lie in there?
My fingers have been crossed. I wasn't born yet when the Leafs won their last cup, so I'm hoping within the next couple years we can see a Stanley Cup. It'd be great to have it this year, so we'll see what happens.
That would be pretty great. Is there anything else you'd like to add, Marcello?
I just want to say that the amount of positive feedback we've received from both our customers and colleagues about Maple Leaf Gardens, our fresh first offering along with our customer service and our competitive price point, I just think makes Maple Leaf Gardens what it is today. So
awesome. Well, thank you so much for having me. I had a great time chatting with you, and back to the studio.